One of the main reasons I fell in love with psychology was really because of this idea that childhood shapes who we are. Going back to Freud and the beginning of object relations and all of those amazing early psychoanalytic theories really just made me fall in love with these ideas. And attachment and those theories, I just truly believe with all my heart that this combination of our genetics and our environment and very much the piece of our experiences truly do shape who we become. And to me, nowhere is that more true than with childhood trauma. And so today's video is all about understanding there are 12 very common signs that you may have experienced childhood trauma, and I'm going to go through those in just a minute. Before I get started though, I'm Dr. Kim Sage. I'm a licensed clinical psychologist, and I hope you'll consider subscribing and clicking the bell and joining this little community that's growing. It's really been amazing. And every time someone shares with me that they feel validated, that they feel understood, it makes all of this learning to use YouTube and videos and trying to, you know, in my sweatshirt on a Sunday, keep going, because I truly do love what I do and I love sharing this information. And it's just not always easy to get. So thank you so much for watching. The top most common signs that you have maybe experienced childhood trauma are really found in the research. They're highly supported in literature, and none of these are really sort of unexpected signs, right? So the first one that I'm going to make a whole series of videos on is really about this idea of how childhood trauma shapes our DNA, shapes our brains, shapes how our bodies respond to in terms of hormones and cortisol and all of those things. But the truth is that if you have had a childhood with trauma filled in it, especially repetitive trauma, but even, you know, at one time trauma, you are much more at risk for having chronic health issues. And what I'm talking about here are things like autoimmune diseases like lupus and RA, things like chronic migraines and headaches, gastrointestinal issues like Crohn's and IBS, everything from cancer, diabetes, and heart disease. These are very well documented, especially things like also fibromyalgia, things that we can't always find a root for, but we know exists. And the truth is that trauma exists in the body. The body has to respond to traumatic experiences with chemicals, with structural change. And so if you have a chronic health issue, this may be one of the signs, not by itself, but in conjunction with the other ones, that you've experienced childhood trauma. The next thing that we often see with childhood trauma are chronic mental health issues. Things like depression, anxiety, PTSD. Of course, we also have things like OCD and the personality disorders that were, you know, many times a part of, you know, genetics, but also had to evolve to survive childhood. And so chronic mental health issues. The third most common sign in terms of having traumatic childhood experiences is the fact that if you find yourself overly reliant upon substances, you know, alcohol, marijuana, you know, pills, anything like that, you may have had a traumatic childhood and may be inadvertently trying to cope with your childhood by trying to choose something to help you deal with the flood of trauma, even including cigarette smoking. It's also well documented that those with significant trauma, historically speaking, have smoked cigarettes more. And it does provide some relief, and I'll come back to that in another video. But just the general use of substances to numb and regulate emotion can very much be a part of childhood trauma. Number four is a tendency to dissociate, a tendency to space out and kind of go somewhere else. This could be part of ADHD or focus or memory issues, and memory issues in general. So all of those in terms of how the brain deals with the past and the present can be another sign of childhood trauma. Number five is if you are harshly critical and a perfectionist type of person. These are very clear signs sometimes with the other ones that you had to survive your childhood by trying to always assess how to protect yourself, how to get it right, how to be safe, and also internalizing that sort of negative, often maternal or paternal experience and rejection often creates a very harsh lens we put on ourselves. And so being highly critical or perfectionistic is also a sign. The next one is toxic shame. And really this toxic shame is really this concept that we feel worthless, we feel we have no value, we feel stupid or ugly. And it really is the core of what I discussed in this video, which is that I am bad, that at the core there is something deeply wrong with me. The next one is that we often live in survival mode. Because we had to survive our childhoods, especially in a chronic situation of trauma, but even if it's a one-time event, we have to be activating these fight or flight, freeze or fawn. I'm gonna come back to those also in another video, but we wanna understand that our body had to respond and prepare for attack, for escape, to almost associate and freeze like we see in frequent sexual abuse in children. And so, or fawning, where you have to sort of like make it all good for the caregiver to be okay. And so you should know that living in survival mode on some level, which can really feel like a heightened anxiety level and or a very low, you know, depressed, sympathetic nervous system functioning that's not healthy, or parasympathetic nervous system that's really not helpful. The next issue is kind of goes with that idea of toxic shame, but it really is lack of worthiness in general. So no matter what we do, even if we can see that we perform something well and we're not necessarily feeling ashamed about it, we can never take ownership or value. We always expect to fail deep inside or see ourselves as failures and or may fear success, because at the core, there's a worthlessness there that no matter what happens, doesn't often change. Number 9 is emotional flashbacks. And emotional flashbacks are sudden emotional regressions back to feeling states in childhood where we felt those feelings of worthlessness, fear, shame, abandonment, regret, rage, grief, sadness. Anything that sort of transports us back to that regressed state in childhood can be part of emotional flashbacks. And I discussed those in this video if you want to check that out. Number 10 is we often have control issues. We like to be in control. We're always managing and trying to like back everything up from the worst case scenario, or we feel out of control. But the need to be in control is a vital part of surviving childhood. And so it gets really reinforced in childhood, right? Because the more you can control, the safer you are, the more you can minimize or reduce harm. But we often take this strategy into adulthood, and being a controlling person or trying to control situations can be another sign. Number 11 is that when you have had a traumatic experience in childhood, you often have really difficult issues with feeling trust and safety in other people. You tend to often isolate and only trust yourself. You tend to feel safest with yourself. And at the core, we often believe that nobody will ever truly be there for us and no one is truly safe. I think sometimes with our kids, we can feel this because there's less of a threat, but when it comes to other adults, and especially if we don't have a personality disorder, you know, we're pretty decently functioning with our trauma. Our kids can feel safer as they grow. Sometimes they get older, that can be triggering, and that's a whole different issue, which I believe I discussed in this video. But the reality is that not having a safe ability to trust others and a sense of security and stability can be a great hallmark of trauma. Thanks so much for watching. Take care and stay safe. I'll see you soon.